Hello there, my name is Joe DeVault, and this is my Lab 3 workload analysis presentation. There are four sections to this presentation. The first one is the assignment requirements, where I discuss the outline or the requirements for the Lab 3. And then I'll go over the experiment design, basically the setup, the code I used, and the optimizations I chose and why. For the experimental execution section, I'll discuss the baseline results and talk about the results for the three optimizations that we chose. And then I'll finish up by talking about the major differences I saw between the optimizations and the rationale I saw for the differences. In terms of the setup requirements, I selected four workloads, workload 1A, 1B, and 3C. I wanted to evaluate both single and multi-threaded workloads. I wanted to stress CPU and memory, and these four workloads do that. Program 1A and 1B stress the CPU through algorithms. Program 3A and 3C stress memory through read-write operations and using arrays. I established a baseline for the CPU and memory performance. Then I selected three optimizations, and I was testing for resource utilization and not so much performance or time duration, because where I work at, that seems to be something I look at more often than outright performance, is how much resources am I utilizing. So as far as the environment or the machine configuration, I used VMware Workstation Pro 14. I had two VMs. One was Windows 2012 Server, and the other was Windows 10 Desktop or Workstation. And again, those are the four workloads I chose. I chose three optimizations. Two were hypervisor optimizations. One was a code optimization. The first one seemed pretty obvious to me. In fact, in hindsight, I probably should have added more CPUs. I'm not sure why I didn't throw that one in there, but I did check for I did test increasing the memory. I also tested running two virtual machines inside the hypervisor, and then because I am a programmer, I wanted to do something in code, even though I'm not that familiar with C. I wanted to pick one of the optimizations that involved coding, so I picked the malloc and free, functions to affect the memory allocation. These are the results from the baseline. For program 1A, the CPU average was pretty high. For 1B, it was not that high at all, which makes sense. You're running more threads. I saw a max of four threads on that one. For program 3A, which is not multi-threaded, pretty high CPU, and it went down considerably with the 3C. As far as the results go, for optimization 1, when I increased the memory, what I saw in most cases is that the memory didn't really change much, and so the memory pretty much stayed constant, and in most cases I saw the memory tick up a little bit, so I didn't see the overall positive impact I would have thought I would see by increasing the memory. As far as the malloc and the free, I would have expected that to improve. I'm not sure what those really do, but I would have thought those would have increased the situation, either made the CPU utilization drop or make the memory drop, and the memory stayed constant and the CPU actually went up by 100%. So I wasn't expecting that. And then finally, for running two VMs, I ran the workload 1B and I increased the iteration up to 10,000 iterations, and that caused the CPU to only tick up slightly. I think when I ran one VM, it was 60% CPU, and then it went up to 66. So I did not see a lot of, at this workload, in other words, I ran one VM by itself with 10,000 iterations, and I saw the average CPU at 60%. When I ran two VMs, I only saw it up to 66. So adding the additional VM didn't really cause much more CPU utilization to occur. The major optimizational differences I saw, in all cases, the CPU increased. I have two examples where with optimization 1 on the program 1B, it increased by 35%, and when I made the changes to the code, I saw 100% increase in CPU. So in most cases, I saw the memory not really change much, and I never saw an improvement in the CPU, which kind of was unexpected. I wasn't really thinking that would be the case. The reason for these optimizations I chose is because increasing memory seems like a pretty straightforward optimization. Adding additional VMs is a pretty normal operation. and trying to make changes to code to improve optimization all seem like pretty reasonable optimizations to choose. In the end, I just really was surprised because I would have thought that some of the changes would have either caused the CPU to drop, and overall I didn't see the changes affecting the, I did see the multi-threading cause the CPU to go down, but I didn't see my changes cause that improvement in behavior. So if you have any questions or comments, feel free to email me, and thank you so much.